Hello everyone, this is Dr. Praveen Verma from Adarsh Vidya Mandir, Mount Abu. Today our topic is quantum numbers. Quantum numbers are basically we can say it is address of electron. You know, in atom, subatomic particles like electron, protons and neutrons are present. Protons are present in nucleus in center of atom and electron revolves in different orbits around the nucleus. So, actually if we see where the electrons are present, so in atom there are orbits and orbits are further divided into suborbit and suborbit are further divided into orbital. So, actually electrons are present in orbital. So, there are four quantum numbers. These are first principal quantum number denoted by small n, second is azimuthal quantum number denoted by small l, and third is magnetic quantum number denoted by small m, and last one is spin quantum number that is denoted by small s. Now first, what is principal quantum number? Principal quantum number actually gives information about the distance of the electron from the center of the nucleus, or we can say it gives information about the energy of electron. We have already derived this formula where the radius is 0.529 n square upon z. So we can understand that radius is proportional to what? N square. And the second, we have derived the formula of the energy in which energy is proportional to minus z square upon n square. So the energy is also related to the principal quantum number. And as the value of the n increases, the energy also increases. Now what is the value of the n? If we see the value of the n, that is from 1, 2, 3, 4 and up to what? Infinite. Infinite means the electron is out of atom. It means there is no electrostatic force of attraction between the nucleus and electron. So that was the principal quantum number. Now second, what is azimuthal quantum number? It is denoted by small l and it gives information about the suborbit. And for any given value of the n, the value of the l is 0 to n minus 1. So if the value of n is 1, there is only one value for the l, that is 0. And if we have the value of the n is 2, then the value of l is 0 and 1. There are two values. And in similar way, if we have the value of the n is 3, then there are three values of the l, 0, 1 and 2. And if the value of the n is 4, then there are four values of the l, that is 0, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so we can give the symbol for the suborbit. If the value of the n is 1 and value of the l is 0, then the suborbit is 1s. And in similar way, for n is 2, there are two suborbits, 2s and 2p. And for n is 3, there are three suborbits, that is 3s, 3p and 3d. And for value of the n, 4, there are four values of the suborbit, that is 4s, 4p, 4d and 4f. So this topic is finished. We will continue next topic in next period. Thank you.